Hello everybody and welcome once again to Beyond Galactic Science. At the end of the last episode I think we did the Moon Dungeons. Well, today we're going to do the Mars Dungeons. But first I want to do two things actually, so let's get on with it. First one, I want to have a look at this chest because it's full. So I'm going to simply empty that out now. Take out the filter out of here, I think it was, just to have a filter in here. Actually got speed upgrades and a filter, so then everything should just remove out of here fairly quickly. Yes, now we've got some space, so whatever was in the pipes will get unblocked and it can go out. And in fact, I think I'll leave it like that. You can see there's plenty of meat, plenty of seeds, plenty of wheat, plenty of flint, plenty of redstone, plenty of iron, so everything seems to be processing nicely. There should be some gold in there as well. I don't see any in there, but there's aluminium, titanium, plenty of titanium. So the mine chem bit seems to be more better with double compressed cobble. So the next thing I want to do is I want to put down an oxygen compressor, and I'm going to put it down here, and I'm going to put it so this is on the left hand side of this. So what we'll do is we'll simply put this down like that's the oxygen compressor. I don't want that one. Quickly remove that. I want the oxygen collector. Now normally in galactic science you'd have blocks around this thing, but we don't need leaf blocks around it, and we'll put the oxygen compressor on top of it because we're in an oxygen rich environment. Now on the side here you've got a red, which means it's an output. So in this output we take the oxygen pipe and put that down basically like that. Oops, missed. Try again. We'll just move it to this side so I don't hit the compressor. And we'll put it down on top of it. Let's put it down there. If I can do it, I have to press shift, don't I? Or hit the hit, do it like that. So you see those two connect up. If it wasn't in the right place, if you did it on the wrong side, they wouldn't connect to it. In fact, let me demonstrate that just to show you what I'm talking about. If you put them down, say here, it doesn't connect, which means you've got it on the wrong side. Put that back again now, like that. So on this side, we've got an energy cable interface here for, it doesn't actually tell you what it is, but it's the power one. So we'll put down two energy conduits on here like this, and one on top of that. I think that'll work. That connects in, so you can see that's now pulling oxygen into here, and you see it's active and oxygen's actually coming in. Normally that would come from leaf blocks, but here we don't. But the idea of this is you put a tank in here, so it's a spare tank. Now I want one in the TARDIS because we're going to go travelling to some of the galactic science or the galactic planet dimensions, and they require oxygen, so that's why we have it. In fact, if you also have a look in my inventory here, you have this extra tab where you can see we've got an heavy duty oxygen, so I can take that out. It doesn't use up this one. I can put that into here, it then fills up. Didn't take very much because I wasn't outside very long, and then we just put that back in again. These are very important as well, thermal padding for some of the galactic science dimensions, especially places like Pluto, which is extremely cold, and Venus, which is hot. And if you go to these, you actually will die. You get a little bar. So, and here we've got a frequency modulator for hearing things which are around, because that also, being we're in a vacuum normally on planets. And then we can hear things which are around. And here's a parachute. Just seeing it then. That's your mask and that's your goggles, your tanks, and that's the rest of it. So let's get on and do this. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to go, well, to the RF tools dimension. I don't want to take the TARDIS with me because I don't want the TARDIS picking me up again. Wait a few seconds to load up. There we go. So today we shall go to Mars. Let's have a look what I've got on the dialing device. So Moon goes to Mars. Fantastic. That's already dialed. Let's check it. Okay. And yes, we'll just take with us. I wonder if I've got any charcoal in here. Well, I've got 64. That'll be fine. And I'm going to put this back in the bag here. My Yetta wrench, don't need that at the moment. We'll have that. We'll have. Oh, we need food, don't we? We also need food. Even in the TARDIS, you need food, so just go and trundle off to the Mars base. And I've already done. Wait a few seconds. So this is actually the first place you come to in when you're actually starting off in Galactic Science. And this is a typical compressor here. So I've got an oxygen collector and a compressor and a power supply. Power supply is actually being fed by hydrogen, which is up in this hopper here. Doesn't use actually that much, and it doesn't use any when it's actually not active. Then I had a tank of water and a tank of lava and the dialing device to get back home again. And this one is powered with charcoal. That's what I wanted the charcoal for. And it doesn't use very much either, so that's fine. So I don't know whether it's day or night. Doesn't make any difference for us. We're going to fly. Now I should have two markers set up, dungeon two, because I was between episodes. I went around and looked for some dungeons. I'll only do one dungeon. That's 1,200 blocks away. That's probably the nearest one. Let's go to this one. And as you can see, if I actually go a bit slower, let it paint in. The terrain in Mars is quite a lot more interesting than it is on the Moon. It's a bit more hilly. It's not as extreme as the Europa or whatever it was, but that wasn't a Galactic Science one. Because you can see in the top left-hand corner of the screen, the oxygen tanks. And the one on the left-hand side beside that is the heat. So if you get too hot and too cold. We're not very far away now. And this is what the dungeons look like. You come to them and you can see right round to bedrock down there. And it gets green. So that's what you're looking for when you're travelling around. They're actually smaller than Moon ones. And therefore, actually, let's get my weapon in hand here. Actually, I should even start to use the bow, because the bow's great as well. Let's actually position the bow into the second slot. I've got infinity on this, that's why I've only got one arrow. And here we simply see some of the minerals which are in Mars. So that's Deshaw, that's very valuable to start with. And this is the iron ore. So you get iron and Desh here as well. Oops, I missed that one. And it makes this cool sort of watery type sounds as well. So let's drop down here. Oops, I've fallen into cobwebs. Let's break these cobwebs before the monster spawn. There we go. Another one over here. And it's the same stuff as before. Something's going bang. Don't ask me what. There's a spider. We'll take on the spider. Shouldn't be too much difficulty. Break the chest. There we got a creeper coming along. That's an evolved creeper because it's got it's right, good. It's a good example now. I can use the bow. The bow's actually got it's better than the ordinary bow. It doesn't drop as much. There he is. Oh, he's trapped in the cobwebs. That's cool. Let's go back to number one. Three. They all got trapped. I normally would put torches down. In fact, I think I actually have got some with me today. Let's have a quick look. Let's see if we can pick up quite a few things in that last chest, including some ender seeds again. Another four ender lily seeds. Brilliant. Don't need them anymore, of course, but that's fine. Golden bag of holding, I think it's this one. I've got some torches in. I didn't see them last time, but I've got plenty. I'll put them at the bottom. So you normally just go along here and put these down. And these are sulfur torches, which are actually better than the standard torch. Before I do that, let's get back to shooting some of these guys. So it's fairly effective as well. It's one sort of hit weapon most of the time. I'm missing him for some reason or other. Oh, well, never mind. Let's go back to this and deal with this guy here. Oh, two skeletons. Of course, this is the creeper base. The boss here is a creeper. The previous boss was a skeleton. Oh yes, they're quite slow, the things on here as well. The arrows, they fly quite slowly, it's quite funny. Right, here we go. I'm missing him. Remember going over his head? Oh, yes. We dropped some redstone. That's unusual for a creeper. Oops, that's just the pet. So here we are, the boss chamber. Oh, not quite the boss chamber yet. We've still got a few more things to deal with. But this weapon is amazing. Well, there's quite a lot of mobs around, you can see on the map. Spider. Next spider. Whee! They must have spawned just as I was going past that, huh? Oops. Didn't do that very well, did I? Ah, moon rock. Not very many chests in this particular clue slot. Didn't get me that. Oh, I missed that one. That's not last time. I think I got. No, this must be the boss chamber. And the boss chamber is a lot more different. So if we can we break this creeper egg? No. Can we right click it? Shift right click it? No. So as we appear in here, we should get the boss. Here he comes. And what he does, he throws TNT at you, and we, you know, what you have to do is bash it back at him, like that. Well, try to anyway. You can't destroy him any other way. It might just make a bit of a mess, mind you. Oops. As you hit him, get it right, that is. I'm missing a bit. There we are. Go. He loses heads. Missed that one. Wait for him to come and do some more TNT stuff. Oops. So you're playing pinged. I don't think I did this better last time, actually. So you're playing ping pong pool with a creeper boss. TNT, good, isn't it? And that was a baby. That was a baby's creeper as well. Come on, you. Shoot some more. I can actually hit. There we go. So this is fairly dangerous normally. Actually, I've lost some. I probably need to eat something, but I'm thinking more for them. It's now he's lost one of his heads. Now that probably means one of these is going to. I might be inventing this before. Come on. Taking a bit of a time doing this one, I do apologize. It is quite a challenge. Ugh. I can actually hit him. He's one third down. I see some of these little guys have spawned. They come to me. Gets you redstone. Oh, that's good. Doing a bit better then. Good for, they knock you out, which is a bit of a nuisance. Don't seem to do too much damage to the actual base itself, do they? I think I do more to the base. Oops, the dungeon, I mean. Well, he's half down, so there must be some more little. Oops. Which you can't leave. If you leave, then he basically reforms to being complete again. Wait for that clip. I'm using the magnet. Gosh, I'm being fairly useless today, I must admit. I don't know if it's better being near him or further away. Ah, oh, now he's gone to an evoked state, which is his last phase. This is actually where you can't damage him at all. I think this is the bit you have to really do use the TNT against. I think before I could have actually used my nice weapon against him. Being a bit nearer, huh? One of the little creepers going to go off in a second. When you get thrown up at, ah, there he goes, now he's done. Anybody else around? And this is where he dropped his key. And gives you lots of experience. What actually I've got here, I've got obviously no inventory space. Let's just do something on my inventory first of all. I should have some space in this one. So let's dump the cart. Pick up the glowstone as well. Always good to have a bit of glowstone around. Plenty of actually glowstone, don't really need it. So that was that. Now where does he... I came from that direction, didn't I? I think that's the last of the mobs, actually, and I should eat. Ah, I hear a zombie. But I think he's on the other side of the walls, because once you get here, all you've got to do is to put down the key like this and open the box. I might be able to do it from the right side. And here you get all sorts of things. What have I got this time? This is where you get the Astro Miner, which you can't build, which is a real pain, but yeah. I don't want the disc. I'm not sure I want the wheat. I'll take the redstone, I'll take the psychedelic glasses. I know I've got those from before. I've got some more lily seeds, another mundane lengthening crystal, some more DU bullets. Don't need any of that. Don't really need any bread. So that'll do for that. What else have I got in here that I really don't need to take with me? Probably don't need this wheat either, do I? Take a bucket, you know. A bucket's a bucket. I'll take the bread. I'll sort that. In fact, we'll take this. Tell you what we all do. We'll take this. Let's put some more stuff away. Got some space. Skelly head from somewhere or other. and a useless bow. Don't really need the bow. Definitely put the bow back and take this record, because you never know, you can always convert that one to the others, and I've got tons of those, don't care about that. So that is it. So let's trundle back to the, so everything's now safe. In fact, I could teleport my way back to them, but it would take me to the moon, but to the moon base. I don't want to go there yet. So you haven't put any torches down because of my night vision. It is quite a long, long path. That's where I put my torches down at the beginning, huh? And we got another skeleton. Oops. Where do they come from? So this is what happens when you get this. You get the sort of knockback effects from these guys. They're quite pain. Oops. Right. They must have spawned when I was outside because I didn't put in torches down. Fly up. I'm not going to do the other dungeon. Don't need to really. As you can see, what I should have possibly done is to mark the base, and I've forgotten where it was. Let's have a quick look at the map. That's probably the easiest way, because I did actually include that, and I think it's up here. Yes, because you got the green. It's where the it's where the mining's been going on with the ender quarry. Converts everything to dirt, and then the dirt gets grass on it, and the grass gets flowers on it. It's quite nice, really. There's always that little black square there. Must be something very special. Don't know what it is. It's also in every single dimension. Here we go. Where is the base? So I actually didn't do too much mining here, as you can see. And I haven't actually even picked up the ender quarry, because the ender quarry is here, the markers are here. I don't need the minerals from here anymore either, so we've got plenty of dash. And here's the ender quarry, and this is always the setup I was using in all the cases. So this is a dimensional chest here. You can open that, and you see things coming in all the time, but from all the dimensions. So at the moment we're getting stuff from Mercury and Venus, I think those two are working away. And all I've got here is one generator, a sterling generator with an octet capacitor in there, so it gives you a reasonable about 80 RF per tick. Oops, what am I doing? I'm not sure what that was. And here is the B-Space barrel from Jabba, and you can see this is, it's nearly always full. Right, let's go back inside. So I did a little bit of mining, and of course here I just put in a magnum torch. Nearly always when you get to a base, keeps the mobs at bay. And my very first bit of mining was down there, so. Right, so this is named Mars, dialed to moon. Oh, I didn't realise it said that. Let's do that and go back again. So now we're back in the moon, and I probably could have used the transmat when I get to there, couldn't I? Let's have a look. So I think that's probably about it for this episode. I don't think there's anything else, a bit shorter than normal. As you can see, things are getting put away. We could, of course, put all of these things in here. I don't know what happened to my amazing technical glasses last time. I did actually have some. Let's put some of this stuff away. I don't really need it, do we? Doesn't work, I've forgotten. I'm thinking I can drag the mouse across, and I can't. Quantron crystals. And the trouble with the Astro Mine, it would be great. Let's have a quick look at that before I tell you about it. So the Astro Mine is this thing here. And to make it, you need five of these Orion drives, and that's the problem. We've got the schema, because the problem is diamond ore and lapis ore and redstone ore, gold ore of course, but that would be fine. Mercury we could do, but these are vanilla ones, and there's no earth. That's also no problem. That's Mars, illuminate ore. Actually, I haven't seen any of that. Probably need to get a bit more mining and cheese ore from the moon. It says moon block there. So all of these are possible, but these ones just aren't possible. There's no recipe for that at all. You just have to mine it, but you've got no silk touch, wouldn't be a problem. But unfortunately, we don't have anywhere that I've found yet so far with diamond on it. Maybe I'm wrong. If there was, I'd go and have a look at it, because it's quite a lot of fun. Next time, I'm not 100% sure. Maybe we'll go and visit some more of the galactic science, actually, while I'm here. And if I install this, let's actually fill up my oxygen tank. I noticed it was getting a little bit full. 53 left. Let's just put it in there and let that fill up to 2,700. In fact, we might as well put the technical colour green gold on. I'm not sure if they actually do anything special. I think that would probably be better for the other place with the other place. Where you get the key from, the TARDIS key. That little guy, that little dimension, because that is really cool. So let's go back and take this. I'll leave that. Okay, I won't Twitter on anymore, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.